Good morning. So today we are discussing the 11th topic and third session. This 11th topic, I am telling every class, 11th topic means first topic sets and relations, second topic binomial theorem, third topic permutation, like that. So 11th topic, and it is the third session in parabola. So in the third session I am solving the 13th problem. 12 problems always already discussed. I would also like to tell you that here in this session I am not going to discuss the basics, the fundamentals, the definitions, the theorems, etc., because it will require a lot of time. Already you have taken classes, have been done hours together in your plus 1, plus 2, that is first PC, second PC, and also you have attended many, might be you have attended many professional classes for entrance exams. So here only wherever needed, wherever required urgently, I might explain, but you should be strong in your fundamentals. Within the time and within the space, I will try to explain wherever necessary and wherever I feel like explaining or wherever I can explain. So with all this in the mind, I can say that this will be a very good subject class for you. This would be a very good class, very helpful class for you, only if you are seeing 1 month before the exam for revision purpose. Certainly in mathematics it will be a very good revision for you. Okay, I hope you understood. Now we go to the 13th question. A tangent is drawn to the parabola y equals x squared plus 6 at the point 1,7, which also touches the circle x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0 at a minus 8 minus 6, b minus 7 minus 6, c minus 6 minus 7, and d 6,7. So once again I'll explain. A tangent is drawn to the parabola y equals x squared plus 6 at the point 1,7. A tangent is drawn to the parabola y equals x squared plus 6 at the point 1,7. It also touches the circle x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0 at the point minus 8, minus 6, b minus 7, minus 6, c minus 6, minus 7, and d 6,7. Now the given parabola is, I hope you understood the question. The given parabola is y equals x squared plus 6. I will take it as 1. The given parabola is y equals x squared plus 6. I will take it as 1. And the given circle is x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0. I will take it as 2. The given parabola is y equals x squared plus 6. That is taken as equation 1. And the given circle is x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0. Now tangent at 1,7 to 1. Tangent at 1,7 to 1. Okay, tangent at the point 1,7 to 1. What we do first? We find the slope. And slope is given by dy by dx. At the point, many methods to find the slope, if you know angle, all these things. Here I am using the derivative, differentiation part of slopes. That is, if a tangent touches the curve at the point x1, y1, then dy by dx, the differentiation of that curve at the point x1, y1 will give you the slope of that tangent. So this is the basic. So what I do, I differentiate dy by dx, I get 2x, and dy by dx at the point 1,7, x is 1, that is 2. So equation is y minus y1 equals m into x minus x1. Equation is y minus y1 equals m into x minus x1. So y minus 7 equals m is 2 into x minus x1, that is x minus 1. Okay. So simplify this, we will get 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0. That is equation 3. We will get 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0. That is equation 3. Okay. Now, any line perpendicular to 3 is, any line perpendicular to 3 is, that is the equation of the tangent, any line perpendicular to 3 is, this line, this is 3, okay, any line perpendicular to this line, again there comes a formula here, See, suppose there is a line in straight lines. You have many methods to find that. You can find the slope also and do it, because you know if two lines are perpendicular, product of the slopes is minus 1. So if there is a line ax plus by plus c equals 0, then any line perpendicular to ax plus by plus c equals 0 is bx minus ay plus k equals 0. So take a line ax plus by plus c equals 0. Any line which perpendicular to ax plus by plus c equals 0 is bx minus ay plus k equals 0, where this k we have to find out. So if find out the slope of both of this, you will get product as minus 1. Okay, so using this formula now, see, 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0, any line, that is this line, any line perpendicular to 3, that is we want this line or CQ, is given by, see, a is 2, b is minus 1, a is 2, b is minus 1, compare from here. So bx, that is minus 1x, bx minus ay, a is 2 plus 2, so minus ay, minus 2y plus k equals 0. So if you want to verify, you can find the slopes, the product. For example, here the slope will be minus a by b slope. Okay, that will be minus 2 by minus, that is 2. Here slope will be minus a by b again, minus of minus 1 by minus 2. So it will be minus 1 by 2. So multiplying, you will get minus 1. So totally, x plus 2y plus k equals 0. Any line perpendicular to 3 is x plus 2y plus k equals 0. That is equation 4. Okay. Now, this line, x plus 2y plus k equals 0, it passes through the point. That is, it passes through the point. That is, see, here you can see. We find the center of the circle. We find the center of the circle. Okay. We find the center of the circle. How to find? From this 2g equals 16, so g is 8, 2f is 12, f is 6, so minus g minus f, minus 8, minus 8, minus 6. So when it is perpendicular, always it should pass through the center. So radius is perpendicular to the tangent at the point of contact. You all know geometry basics if you know. Okay, what happens then? It passes through this. So this line is minus x minus 2y plus k equals 0. It passes through this, so x is minus 8. Y is minus 6. It satisfies the equation. We can find K, and K is 20. So if K is 20, equation of CQ is X plus 2Y plus 20 equals 0. Equation of PQ is 2X minus Y plus 5 equals 0. So now we want here, what we want here? Tangent is drawn at the point which also touches the circle. Okay. Tangent is drawn to the parabola at the point P1,7, which also touches the circle at C. Tangent is drawn to the parabola, actually it is from the point, say from the point 1,7, it touches, we want this Q. So Q is the point of intersection of 3 and 4, here it is 5 and 6. Okay, it's written as 5 and 6, okay, so or 6 and 5, whatever. So solving, we get Q minus 6 minus 7. So Q minus 6 minus 7 means option C. Okay, I followed it, I explained it. Try to know the basics. Without the basics, you will not know. Any doubt, please ask me. Once again, I explain a bit faster now. A tangent is drawn to the parabola y equals x squared plus 6 at the point 1,7, which also touches the circle x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0. Okay, at the point, what is the point? Minus 8, minus 6, first option, B, minus 7, minus 6, minus 6, minus 7, 6, 7. Okay, the given parabola is, what is the given parabola? Y equals x squared plus 6, that is 1. And the given circle is x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0. Given parabola is y equals x squared plus 6. And the given circle is x squared plus y squared plus 16x plus 12y plus c equals 0. Okay, now tangent at 1,7, it passes through 1,7. So y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1 is the equation of straight line with slope m and point x1, y1. 1,7 is a point on the tangent, you can see. So to find the slope here, we use differentiation, it will be easier, of the curve. Dy by dx will be 2x, but it will be at the point, that is 1,7, at the point 1,7, that is actually 2 into 2, that is 2, 2 into 1, 2, okay, 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0, okay, so I hope this you followed, so slope if you find here, it is same, slope is same, okay, now, we get 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0. Now, any line perpendicular to this 3, that is, we use this formula, ax plus by plus c equals 0 is bx minus ay plus k equals 0. So, we get x plus 2y plus k equals 0. Now, this line perpendicular, it passes through the center of the circle. From the equation of the circle, I find the center, g is 8 and f is 6. So, I get the center as minus g minus f minus 8 comma minus 6. So, it passes through minus 8 comma minus 6. So, I get k as 20. So, if I get k as 20, equation of CQ is x plus 2y plus 20 equals 0. And equation of PQ is 2x minus y plus 5 equals 0. We want this Q, which is the point of intersection of PQ and CQ. So, solving, adding, subtracting, Cramer's rule, any method which is easy for you. So, solving simultaneous linear equation, multiplying by 2, subtracting, all that, you know that basic. So, Q is minus 6, minus 7. So, then it is option C. I hope now you have followed it. Still any doubt, please contact me, I'll explain. Now, question number 14. The locus of the vertices of the family of parabolas. See, the locus of the vertices of the family of parabolas, y equals a cubed x squared by 3 plus a squared x by 2 minus 2ae. The locus of the vertices of the family of parabolas. Okay, understand the question. The locus of the, locus means the path traced by the moving point under certain geometrical condition. This word is coming again and again. Certain geometrical conditions, under that the point moves, when it moves it forms a curve or a straight line. What is the equation of that? That is called as the locus. The locus of the vertices of the family of parabolas, y equals a cubed x squared by 3 plus a squared x by 2 minus 2a. So, locus of the vertices. Answer is xy, 105 by 64. Second option, xy equals 3 by 4. Third option, xy equals 35 by 16. Fourth option, xy equals 64 by 105. Okay. So, what we do here? See, the family of parabolas is given here. I write it again. Y equals a cubed x squared plus a squared x by 2 minus 2a. I wrote family of parabolas. Now I try to simplify this and try to find out, write in the form of, I try to write it in the form of a standard form of parabola. Standard form of parabola, you know, y squared equals 4x, center vertex is origin, or x squared is equal to 4x. And when the vertex is shifted to h, k, what will be, you know, there are four types of parabola. All these are the basics. I cannot go on explaining this again and again. So what I do, I divided by a cubed by 3 throughout. So I got like this, this x squared. So a squared by 2, when I divide by a cubed by 3, it will be multiplied into 3 by a cubed. You know, division will be multiplication of the reciprocal into x minus 2a by a cubed by 3. Then I bought all the terms. I want to make it a perfect square, yeah, because x squared is there here. Because you know, x minus h whole squared or y minus k whole squared. So x squared is there. What I do, I write x squared and I come here, I write 2 into x, 2a, a squared plus 2a, so 2 into x. So this 2 is extra, so I multiply and divide by 2, so I get 4a here. So totally 2 into 1a get cancelled, a squared get cancelled, only 3 by 4a into x. So a squared plus 2a and this is b, so a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So, 3 by 4a whole squared, that is 9 by 16a squared. So, when I add, I have to subtract also. So, I get minus 9 by 16a squared. Okay. So, I get here finally 3y by a cubed plus 6 by a squared. This extra, I will bring this side. This adding and subtracting, you know that plus 9 by 16a squared equals x by plus 3 by 4a whole squared. So, I can write it as finally rearranging and writing. That's all. See, here this and this can be added. They are like terms. 6 plus 9 by 16 will be 105 by 16 a squared, like that. So, I get x plus 3 by 4 a whole squared equals 3y by a cubed plus 105 by 16 a squared. Here, I will remove the constant outside, whichever is constant. So, x plus 3 by 4 a whole squared equals 3 by a cubed into y plus 35 by 16 a. So, now this is of the form, this is clearly of the form x minus h whole squared is equal to 4 a into y minus k. X minus h whole squared is equal to 4a into y minus k. Okay. If we take alpha and beta, h comma k, I took. If you take alpha and beta, if alpha comma beta is the vertex, If you take alpha comma beta as the vertex, then x minus h or x minus alpha comparing, so it will be alpha is minus 3 by 4a, 4a, this will be 4a into this, not this a, this capital A, 4a, to y minus k, y minus k or y minus beta. So beta is minus 35 by 16a. So when I get this, then see what is the question, we'll see. So the locus of the vertices, we want just locus of the vertices. So vertex here is alpha comma beta. So locus of the vertices means we are connected only with alpha and beta. So we'll multiply alpha beta equals, no other variable will be there. Alpha beta equals AA cancels 105 by 64. So locus of alpha beta is XY equals 105 by 64. That is option A. XY equals 105 by 64. That is option A. So once again, I'll explain. The locus of the vertices of the family of parabolas, y equals a cubed x squared by 3 plus a squared x by 2 minus 2a is, first option xy equals 105 by 64, second option xy equals 3 by 4, third option xy equals 35 by 16, and fourth option xy equals 64 by 105. Okay, and then the family of parabolas, the family of parabolas, you can see here, is y equals a cubed x squared by 3 plus a squared x by 2 minus 2 as given in the question. Now I try to write it in the standard form of parabola, either if the vertex is alpha comma beta, x minus alpha whole squared is equal to 4a into y minus k, or if it is another type, that is y minus beta whole squared is equal to 4a into x minus h. I try to simplify it. I divide throughout by a cubed by 3, then I get x squared. I want x squared first. So I divide by that. Then I try to complete the square method. I see this will be 3y by a cubed. I bring this 3 into 2, 6 by a squared. 6a by a cubed means 6 by a squared. Then a squared. I want plus 2ab. So I multiply and divide by 2. So 2 here it will be 4. Multiply and divide by 2. Then 2a. Remaining is 3 by 4a. So 2a into b. So b is 3 by 4a. So plus b squared. That is 9 by 16 a squared. This extra. So if I add, I have to subtract. Minus 9 by 16 a squared. This I will take it to the other side. 3 by a cubed plus 6 by a squared plus 19 by 9 by 16 a squared equals. This is a squared plus 2ab plus b squared is a plus b. That is x plus 3 by 4a whole squared. So I can write it as x plus 3 by 4a whole squared equals 3y by a cubed. These two you add. If you add like terms there, will get 105 by 16 a squared. So I get here x plus 3 by 4a whole squared equals, here I can remove common, that is 3 by a cubed. I'll remove common 3 by a cubed because I want, the standard form is x minus alpha whole squared is equal to 4a into y. Y should be single, x also should be single. The coefficient should be 1 of x and y. So 3 by a cubed outside, so y plus, here if I take 3, the 3 times 35 it will be, then this a cubed, so if I divide by, so I multiply and divide by a cubed, so it cancels. You know how to do all this, dividing, multiplying, adding, subtracting all. Now I take, let alpha comma beta be the vertex and compare with the standard form, x minus alpha whole squared is equal to 4a into y minus k, so alpha is minus 3 by 4a and beta is minus 35 by 16a. We want the locus of the vertex. So we have to form an equation in the vertex, that is alpha beta, and replace alpha by x and beta by y. So alpha beta equals 105 by 64. So locus of alpha comma beta is xy equals 105 by 64. That is option A. I hope it is clear. Now we go to the 15th question. Okay. We go to the 15th question now. A bit small question. So angle between the tangents to the curve y equals x squared minus 5x plus 6 at the points 2,0 and 3,0. Direct question. Angle between the tangents to the curve. So only once I am explaining, be attentive. Angle between the tangents to the curve. Angle between the tangents to the curve y equals x squared minus 5x plus 6. At the points 2,0 and 3,0. At the points 2,0 and 3,0. So here we get first option pi by 2, second option pi by 3, third option pi by 6, and fourth option pi by 4. So dy by dx will be 2x minus 5. So m1 will be dy by dx at the point 2,0. So 4 minus 5 is minus 1. M2 will be dy by dx at the point 3 comma 0. Or this M2, M1, this M2, same it is. So we get 3 into 2, 6 minus 5, that is 1. So clearly we can see M1 into M2 is minus 1. That means the slope of the first tangent M1, slope of the second tangent M2, the product of the slopes is minus 1, means the angle between them is per 90 degrees. So pi by 2, 90, pi means 180 degrees. So pi by 2, that is option A. Hope you have followed it. I go to the next question. The axis of a parabola is along the line y equals x. Okay, the axis of the parabola is along the line y equals x. And the distance of its vertex from the origin is root 2. The axis of a parabola is along the line y equals x. Axis means dividing the parabola into two equal parts. So the axis of the parabola is along the line y equals x. And the distance of its vertex from the origin is root 2. And that from its focus, that is distance of the vertex from the focus is 2 root 2. Distance of its vertex from the origin is root 2. And that distance of this same vertex from the focus is 2 root 2. If vertex and focus both lie in the first quadrant, if vertex and focus both lie in the first quadrant, then the equation of the parabola is, if the vertex and focus both lie in the first quadrant, then the equation of the parabola is, first option, x plus y squared equals x minus y minus 2. Second option, x minus y whole squared is x plus y minus 2. Third option, x minus y squared is 4 into x plus y minus 2. And last option, x minus y squared is 8 into x plus y minus 2. Okay, now, see, here you can see very clearly the axis of the parabola is along the line y equals x. Okay. And the distance of its vertex from the origin is root 2. And that from its focus is 2 root 2. So the midpoint, vertex will be the midpoint. Okay, so if vertex is the midpoint and the axis is like this, then the directrix will be like this. That is y equals minus x. This comes from the common knowledge of parabolas. Because the distance between the vertex will be the midpoint of the distance between the directrix and the focus along the axis. Okay, so equation of the directrix is y equals minus x. Just try to understand this. Equation of the directrix is y equals minus x, that is x plus y equals 0. Now equation of the parabola is, so distance from the focus, the locus of the point which moves such that the distance from the focus is equal to the length of the perpendicular from the directrix. The point moves such that distance from the focus is equal to its length perpendicular to the directrix. So that definition we use. So x minus 2 whole squared plus y minus 2 whole squared. X minus 2 whole squared plus y minus 2 whole squared is equal to x plus y by root 2. Want this, I have just to be like this. See, just for understanding, this is the parabola. This is the rough diagram clearly telling you this is y equals x. Okay, now distance of the vertex is vertex from the focus. It's given distance of the vertex from the origin is root 2. So if I take here, see. So here to here it will be root 2. Here it will be root 2. Okay, root 2. And if this is the focus here, somewhere here focus here, somewhere here if it is the focus, then this will be distance from the vertex is 2 root 2, means this also will be root 2. Distance of the focus from the origin is, so root 2 and root 2. Okay, so clearly now I can make out that the focus will be here. Focus will be here. So if you add this, see if I take here, from here till here it will be. And if I take from here till here, see, this point, if I take from here, if I take from here till here line, so this length will be root 2 plus root 2. Okay, this length will be 2. This length also will be 2. Okay, from the definition, this length will be 2 and this length will be 2 because, and the directrix will be here, see. This is y equals minus x, directrix. Hope you followed. Lack of time, I can't explain. Okay, y equals minus x. This is the directrix. So with this idea, hope you followed. So now the distance from the focus, this point will be 2,2. This point will be 2,2 because it is on y equals x. So if x is 2, y also will be 2. It's on the line y equals x here. So if x is 2, y also will be 2. So x minus 2 whole squared plus y minus 2 whole squared is equal to the length of the perpendicular from the focus. That will be length of the perpendicular will be ax plus by for this x plus y 0. So x plus y divided by a squared plus b squared. That is root 2. Okay, from the moving point focus. This, you know. So then we expand it. Simple expansion, squaring both sides, expanding it, then writing like this. So the equation of the parabola is x minus y whole squared is equal to 8 into x plus y minus 2. I hope it is clear because lack of time. The equation of the common tangents to the parabola y equals x squared and y equals minus x minus 2 whole squared is y equals 4x minus 1, y equals 0, y equals minus 4x minus 1, y equals minus 30x minus 50. So equation of the tangent to x squared is equal to y is equal to mx plus c. So it will be minus 1 by 4 by m squared. Equation of the tangent to x minus 2 squared by x minus 2 squared is equal to minus y is equal to m into x minus 2. Same formula, see. Y is equal to m into x minus 2 plus 1 by 4 into m squared formula. So 1 and 2 are identical. It's a common tangent. So it's a common tangent means either m equals 0 or m is equal to 4. Either m is 0 or m is equal to 4. Okay, because identical, they should be same. So the common tangents are y equals 0 or y equals 4. Substitute here, m equals 4, you can get. So common tangents of y equals 0 or y equals 4x minus 4. That is options A and B. 18th one, the equation of a tangent to the parabola y squared is equal to 8x is y equals x plus 2. The point on this line for which the other tangent to the parabola is perpendicular to the given tangent is. So let P be the required point. So then P lies on the directrix. Very easy. That is x equals minus 2. Of y squared equals 8x. So the point is, it lies on the directrix. So the equation of x is y equals 0. So x equals minus 2. So minus 2 comma 0. P is minus 2 comma 0. The 19th one, a parabola as the origin as its focus and the line x is equal to as directrix. As the origin as its focus and the line x equals 2 as the directrix. Then the vertex of the parabola is at 2,0, 0,2, 1,0 and 0,1. In this conic section, you should picturize half of the problem is solved. Since the vertex A is the midpoint of OZ, see, vertex A, I have drawn the x is equal to directrix. The focus is the origin drawn here. So, A is the midpoint of OZ by the definition. Vertex A is the midpoint of OZ, so A will be 0 plus 2 by 2 and 0 plus 0 by 2, that is 1,0. Here the important concept is always the vertex will be the midpoint of the OZ. Okay, so the time is up. I wind up the session here. All the best. Thank you.